part of the geometric progression, that is part 2. You're welcome. I hope you're watching my videos. Thank you for giving me so much love. Now I am coming to the question. I have, you know, what is the purpose of this video? Here I am bringing some important question of GP. And first of all, before going to the question, I want to show you an important situation in GP. So if A, B, C are in GP, it means if we have three terms in GP, then you know the ratio B upon A will be equal to C upon B. This much we know. But if I am cross multiplying, that is B square equal to AC. You know, this is a very important situation. If three terms are in GP, if we have three terms in GP, then the square of the middle term will equal to the product of the extreme term. So now we will use the same concept in this question. We will use the same concept in this question. These three terms are given in GP. So you know this is the middle term. So according to that situation, the square of the middle term will equal to the product of extreme terms. So now we have x square is equal to, so cancel, cancel, minus minus plus 1, and you know whenever x square is equal to 1, so x may be plus 1 or minus 1. So this is the value of x. So easy question. So for more question, keep watching. See this question. It is given that 5th, 8th and 11th term of a GP are P, Q, S. Then we have to establish a relation between P, Q and S. So first of all, starting, you know 5th term, that is I can write A5 is equal to P. Similarly, 8th term, that is A8 is equal to Q, and A11 is equal to S. Now we know that the term nth term formula for GP, An is equal to AR to the power n. In comparison of n, the power of R will be 1 less than. So use the same technique. I mean, if I am writing down A5, so I will write first term and R to the power 5 minus 1, 4, and it is given P. Similarly, for A8, I will write first term and R to the power 8 minus 1, 7, which is Q. And similarly, for A11, first term into R to the power 11 minus 1, that is 10, is equal to S. To establish this relation, first of all, we will try to find left hand side, that is Q square. So if I am squaring Q, that is AR to the power 7 square, and solving A square and R to the power 14, this is condition 1. Now to get this right hand side, I have to multiply P and S. So P into S. So what is the value of P? See, AR to the power 4 into it. What is the value of S? That is AR to the power 10. Now after multiplying A into A, I am getting A square and 4 plus 10 R to the power, sorry, this is 14, and R to the power 10 plus 4, 14. This is second situation. Now see, in first and second, right hand side same. So if their right hand side same, so we will have left hand side also equal. So Q square is equal to PS, and here we have proved it. So for more question, keep watching. Here we have a mixed question from AP and GP, that is we have to use both the tactics AP and GP. First of all, let us see what is given. It is given that ABC are in AP. You know, whenever three terms are given in AP, it means that twice of the middle term is equal to sum of the extreme term. So this is like a result. We will use this result further. Now we have to show that these three terms are in GP. You know, if we have to show that these three terms are in GP, so we have to show the square of the middle term is equal to the product of the extreme term. So I am taking square of the middle term. You know, laws of exponent, I can write 3 to the power 2b. Now from first you see 3 3 to the power 2b is equal to a plus c. So I can put the value of 2b, that is a plus c. And again, law of exponent, I can write it 3 to the power a into 3 to the power c. Now you see, the square of the middle term is equal to the product of the extreme terms. So we can say 3 to the power a, 3 to the power b, and 3 to the power c are in GP. And we have solved the question. So for more question, keep watching. So it is the last question of the video with us. It is given that the fourth term of a GP is the square of the second term. So that it is given that the fourth term, that is A4, is the square of the second term. So if we are assuming first term is A and common ratio is R, so then the fourth term will be written as A and 4 minus 1, 3. Similarly, the second term will be written as A and R to the power 2 minus 1, that is 1, and square. Now, A R cube is equal to A square R square. You see, 1 power will cancel with this, and you know, so we will left with R is equal to A. But in the question, first term is given, that is A is equal to minus 3, and so R is also minus 3. So now we are having A and R. So now we can calculate seventh term, which will be AR to the power 6. So what is the value of 3? A, that is minus 3. And what is the value of R? That is again minus 3 and power 6. So this way we have minus 3 to the power 7. And you know, negative odd power is negative, and 3 to the power 7. You can simplify it and then solve it, and you can get the answer. So for more topics, for more interesting videos, keep watching my videos and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.